whatever they want, they deserve it. And we held our ground. I mean, I can't speak for the other negotiators up here, but we held our ground. We took a lot of abuse for 13 months. At the end of the day, I was extremely satisfied and extremely proud of the contract that we negotiated with them. Now, I'll be the first to admit, I told Mike this when I met with his committee, we have some work to do. I mean, there are still things that need to be over years of collective bargaining. You cannot undo those things in a period of one or two or three negotiating sessions. It takes a long time to do it. But in fairness to the unions, they're also looking at what's in the best interest of their people. And sometimes the two clash. I mean, right now, the community of North Reading is basically subsidized by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Pure and simple. You know, we can make all the cuts that we want, negotiate all the good contracts we want, but if the state's not going to provide us with the type of aid that is necessary for us to be solvent, then we're pretty helpless. I think Dan's made suggestions, Mike's made suggestions, and I think we, as boards, we have to look at those suggestions and we have to really start to implement a lot of them. Because there is some economies that can be realized here by us tightening our belts and doing business a little bit differently. I'm just not sure that we're ever going to get to a point where we're self-sufficient. I'm not sure on the current system. I think Steve O'Leary described it as a structural deficiency in the past, the way the town government is funded. And it's an extremely difficult situation, and quite frankly, it's like a roller coaster. You know, we get some funding, we got an override a few years ago, the selectmen have pitched in to help out the schools, and we're up here. And then as Mr. Driscoll has said, you know, we're up here, we're doing okay, we're average, and I agree with you, it's average. You know, we're not making we haven't got the offerings that we'd like to have, foreign languages and some of the other classes. So we're up here, and then all of a sudden, as another year or two, fiscal years go by, we're back down here again. And it's just it's a product of the system. I think some good suggestions have been made. I think the GIC thing is something that we really need to pursue. It's probably the single biggest savings that the town can realize. But at the same time, I understand how difficult it is to negotiate these things. And maybe we need to put enough pressure on the bargaining groups to understand that if this doesn't get done, then there are going to be much more drastic measures that are going to have to take place.
I just have one more point, and then I'll get off the stage. The last thing is, Ms. Sarah, you talked about your meeting with other boards of selectmen. Isn't it possible to meet with those other boards of selectmen and create negotiating strategies where other towns get on board with us and support us? Just like the other unions seem to get with other towns, and they all seem to get together collectively, and then they argue as one. It doesn't seem like the other boards of selectmen are getting on board.